With good news for today from Baptist Press, I'm Brandon Porter. Members of the Southern Baptist Convention are processing through the details of a 288-page report on the alleged mishandling of sexual abuse claims released publicly Sunday. The independent investigation examines how the Executive Committee of the Southern Baptist Convention received and acted upon sexual abuse claims over a period of 21 years. The SBC is a convention of around 47,000 churches across the U.S. The SBC meets annually to hear reports and take action in its ministries and business. The next meeting is set for June 14th and 15th in Anaheim, California. Crediting God's tenderness and compassion, Leanne Jameson says pregnant women in crisis often stick to her very soul, causing her to take their concerns to God's altar. The executive director of the Prestonwood Pregnancy Center in Texas meets hundreds of such women each year. Jameson spoke to Baptist Press while preparing for the May 31st opening of the Family Resource Center that will allow expanded and extended care for mothers, fathers, and children with pertinent resources through perhaps the fifth year of life. As the U.S. Supreme Court seems primed to return abortion law to the purview of state legislatures, Jameson suspects the Prestonwood ministry will attract more women in crisis. Texas is among 13 states with laws on the books that will immediately outlaw abortion if the decision is returned to the states.
Good news for today is made possible through our friends at the Voice of the Martyrs, a nonprofit organization that serves persecuted Christians around the world. Founded in 1967 by Richard and Sabina Wormbrand, VOM is dedicated to inspiring believers to deepen their commitment to Christ and to fulfill His great commission, no matter the cost. Find out more and sign up for their free monthly magazine at vom.org/goodnews.
Betty Wiseman considers her path, one that started in tiny Portland, Tennessee, before going through Nashville and winding to the ends of the earth, to be orchestrated by God. The path has centered around her faith and basketball. Wiseman averaged 30 points a game in high school, scoring a one-time record of 45 points at a time when girls' teams played on a divided court with no three-point line. In 1968, she founded the Belmont women's basketball team, one of the first not only in the state but in the Southeast. Wiseman served as the head coach for 16 seasons, leading them to four trips to the National Invitational Tournament from 1973 to 1977. As much as she loves basketball, though, Wiseman adheres to a similar passion for the Great Commission. She took her first overseas mission trip in 1992. She says that time in Chile changed her life. She's still active in her church, lending a hand however her teammates need her. You can read the full story at our website, baptistpress.com. Thanks for listening to Good News for